What I intend with this video is to provide you with some literature that might help you in case you want to delve deeper into manuscript studies beyond this MOOC. There is, of course, a lot of stuff published on this subject, and I cannot review it all, not even for handbooks. Therefore, I'm just offering you here the end of Ariadne's thread so that you can orient yourself in the codicological labyrinth, which instead of one has two minotaurs, being one the price of the books and the other one the difficulty to even find some of them. I will proceed language by language. In English, a favorite of mine is Graham and Clement's Manuscript Studies. This book is simply excellent, with very clear and ordered exposition and many images in full color. Unsurprisingly, you can get it for only a few bucks. I requested mine through a very well-known online shop, and from the price I had paid, I expected a very small and poorly printed book. And so, when I received my copy, I was extremely happy, and even happier when I started to reading it. But for even less, you can get Alessandro Bausi's, I'm not sure about how the name should be pronounced, Comparative Oriental Manuscript Studies, an Introduction. The title is misleading because 700 pages are somewhat more than a simple introduction and because it also deals with Western manuscripts, although always from a comparative approach. This is a collective volume where some of the very best codicologists of the present decade have worked. It is available online for free and you will find the link to it in the materials accompanying this video. If you can read French, congratulations! As a matter of fact, the first handbooks on codicology were written in French, both by French and Belgian specialists. Actually, if you are considering a career in the field of manuscript studies, learning French is something you should consider as well. One of the handbooks I am referring to is Jacques Lemaire's Introduction à la Codicologie. It has been around more than 30 years and has been superseded by newer manuals, but in my opinion, it is still very handy because of its clarity. And I cannot refrain myself from mentioning Léon Gillison's Prolegomène à la Codicologie. This is not a book you will find in smaller libraries, and again, it is very old, even older than Lemaire's, but in many respects it set the standards for codicological studies. More or less the same can be said of the five volumes of the series Codicologica, published in Leiden between 1976 and 1980. Here, however, the aspects addressed are broader, and being the work of a large team during the years when codicology was not yet fully established as an academic discipline, it is not the sort of reading that I would recommend for a beginner. Very recommendable, however, is Lire le Manuscrit Médiéval, edited under the supervision of Paul Guérin. Its approach is again comparative, very fashionable in these days. If you are interested in the most technical questions, you definitely must learn Italian and read Maria Luisa Agati's Il Libro Manoscritto, da Oriente a Occidente, per una codicologia comparata. It is not for a beginner, but keep it in mind for the future. For beginners as well as for advanced students, however, is Marilena Maniaci's Archeologia del Manoscritto, Metodi, Probleme, Bibliografia Recente. It is a cute pocket-sized book. In the first part of it, the author addresses the most relevant questions relating manuscripts in a critical manner, but also very open-minded. The second part offers a very comprehensive, although not exhaustive, list of literature ordered by topic, very useful, and also very affordable. In German, I love Christine Jacobi Mirwald's Das mittelalterliche Buch, Funktion und Ausstattung. It gives a very accurate vision of the evolution of all elements of medieval manuscripts. Definitely a great book. In a very small body. And the price has the same dimensions than the format. But one cannot get everything at once, can one? And the illustrations come only in black and white. Also, if you are near your 50s, you might need a magnifying glass to read it. If you are the sort of person that likes full-color images, you might like Handschriften des Mittelalters, edited under the supervision of Matthias Kluge. It is also a very good introduction, much lighter than Jacobi Myhrvold's, and comes with a DVD that can serve as an even more gentle introduction into the subject. Actually, I don't know why I'm recommending it, because it can be considered a sort of competitor to this MOOC. Never mind. Finally, in Spanish, you have Elisa Ruiz's Introducción a la Codicología. If you cannot read Italian, this could be a good option to learn the most technical stuff. Elisa's exposition is very tidy and very clear, and includes a lot of very useful diagrams and drawings. As the title specifies, it is an introduction with the beginner's needs in mind, but intermediate and advanced codicologists can also profit a lot from it. The only flaws that one can point out are the price and that it is very European-centered, although of course the latter is not actually a flaw as much as the approach chosen by the author. And by the way, this MOOC will be very European-centered as well. That much about handbooks. Another instrument that you might need is a lexicon. And here we are entering into a very muddy terrain, because regretfully terminology fluctuates very much, and that in all languages, and the equivalences between languages can be a little bit tricky. Years ago, Denis Michel published his Vocabulaire Codicologique, which is an instrument I personally couldn't live without, but it is not perfect. It has been fully translated into Spanish, Italian and Romanian, and is available online through the French EHRT, and the entries are ordered thematically, which is very useful. The online version is entirely in French, but includes the equivalences in Italian, Spanish and English, although the English part is still very patchy. For English, we can resource to Michelle Brown's Understanding Illuminated Manuscripts, a guide to technical terms, and the glossary included in the website of the British Library. In my opinion, the main disadvantage of both instruments, which share a lot in common, is that the terms are ordered in alphabetical order, not thematically. And that leaves us with Jan-Peter Gumbert's Words for Codices, but it was never finished, at least to my knowledge. However, several fragments have been circulated in the internet. I guess they have been leaked by the same Jan-Peter Gumbert, and they are excellent. Which is not strange, since Gumbert is one of the giants of our discipline, and therefore even more to regret that the words are still in a draft state. As you see, there is a lot to do in this terrain. Finally, I will mention some periodicals that specialize in manuscripts. Scriptorium is the oldest and probably the most prestigious. It is published by the Centre International de Codicologie of Brussels with some collaboration of the French EHRT, and is closely related to the Bulletin Codicologique, an ongoing bibliography of studies related to medieval manuscripts. My favorite, however, is the Gazette du Livre Médiéval. I love it because it is so unconventional, with quite short articles that sometimes are just sort of first insights in a certain aspect that has not yet been fully explored. In spite of the French title, the Gazette is edited in Switzerland, the articles are published in almost any Western European language. Of course, there are many more. I leave the links to many of them in the documentation section of this lesson.